Micah, and today we're talking about Nancy Drew. Current episode that I've seen is called The Phantom of Bonnie Scott. We have our opening scene, and it's Nancy, and she's making out with Owen. They're kissing, they're caressing themselves, and then Owen turns into Nick, and she tells Nick that she misses him. Girl, do you really? You didn't treat him right. He deserves to be with somebody that treats him right, George. Anyways, all of a sudden she snaps out of it because she hears this bumping under her stairs, which, by the way, she's still in her dream state. So she hears this bumping under her stairs and she goes to go check it out in the cupboard, and then she opens it up and it is like the shelves are moving like boom. And so she wakes up from the dream, goes downstairs to go check and see the cupboard, and she finds a file. She finds a file that belongs to her mom. Which, by the way, I did point out last time that I thought that her mom was involved in some way, somehow, like her mom knew some stuff. Then we kind of find out that her mom was Lucy Sable's guidance counselor, and the file is missing. More like torn out. Then we have Nick, who is officially done with his parole counseling, I believe that's what it is. His parole counseling sessions. And the guy was asking him, like, well, what are you going to do? Blah, 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 blah. You can go see your family. And he's like, nah. Because he spent 2 years in jail. I was like, whoa, really? I didn't know he spent that much time in jail. Then we have a scene. The next scene is Nancy showing up and she's smiling, blah, blah, blah. I'm not with it. The next scene, we have George talking to this woman, which I didn't catch her name. But she's planning on selling the Shack Diner that they hang out at. George is sad about it. Nancy shows up and she's supposed to be working, but she's like, no, I gotta go do something, as usual. Nancy goes to the Hudson's to help her get her dad out of jail. I can't remember his name. The Hudson dad, the head dude in charge. I think his name is Everett. I could be wrong, but I'ma just call him Everett until I Google and find out that his name isn't Everett. So y'all can correct me if I'm wrong. So she goes to Everett Hudson, which is Ryan Hudson's dad, in order to get her dad out of jail. But just like the devil, he wants something in return. He wants her to get something from Owen about the shipwreck that happened. That shipwreck just seems like such a tedious thing compared to everything else going on. But yeah, that's happening. That's the thing. Okay, so Bess is full on British now. Now, that's probably my fault for not paying attention. Consistently paying attention to Bess because I did not know she was not American. And when she started talking in her accent, I thought it sounded fake. I didn't like, I don't say I don't like somebody's voice. It didn't sound natural. So I thought she was faking an accent, only to find out that she was actually faking her American accent. But she sounds more American than she does British. Okay, well, anyway, she's supposed to be going to meet some woman named Diana, which she's a Marvin as well. But Bess and Nancy, they meet up with Owen and they talk to this sole survivor of the shipwreck. And he is a nervous wreck, and rightfully so. Kind of find out, you know, he got ghosts and stuff running rampant all up in his house. Then we have George and Nick. They have a heart-to-heart talk. It was so cute, and apparently he loves her tuna melts. And then right there in that particular scene, you could tell that they're setting up that he's gonna buy the shack. So just in case you didn't know, he buys the shack. Yes, I ruined it. Then we're back to Bess. Bess is moving up the ladder and her family. And okay, so Diana tells her that the Marvins don't marry drivers. Like, they don't care that she's a lesbian. They don't marry drivers. Like, what? Okay, that's something to be picky about. No, it's not, actually. Then we have George and Nick, and they have a heart-to-heart, and he loves her tuna melts. Oh, I just like them so much. They're so cute. Okay, he loves her tuna melts, and pretty much in this scene, you can tell that he's going to buy the shack. Later that night, Nick adds his name to a table at the shack next to George's name, and it is so cute. And it's so cute. And then Nancy comes busting in. She always ruins something. Nancy comes in, and it gets slightly awkward. And George just, you know, basically runs off like, oh, no, nothing's happening, whatever. So Nancy and Nick, they have a conversation, and she's asking him if she's a bad person. And Nick is like giving her a pep talk, like, no, you're not a bad person. You're great. You're amazing. All this other stuff. And it's like, girl, shut up. I really don't like Nancy. You can tell I don't like Nancy. I'm trying. I just don't feel like she has chemistry with anybody on screen. So far, I've seen that her and Owen go well together. But, like, even in her friendships, she has asses her friendships. I'm not even going to bleep that out. she really just isn't consistent about her friends. Not the way that they feel about her. Everybody else got chemistry and stuff for her. Maybe after this season, I may get used to her. If we get a second season, which hopefully we do. I haven't checked to see if they gave it a green light. But maybe I'll... How can I put this? She'll spend so much more time with them that maybe we can see the chemistry. Because as of right now, I don't see chemistry with her or her friends. And if anything, she's just... It's like she's speaking and saying she cares. But you don't see it. Like, it's not being shown. Like, even when she talks to her dad, it's this cold, like, this defense, this wall that she has up. And it's like, where did this wall come from? I know your mom passed, but where did this wall come from? I hope they call her out on that. But so far, they've been giving her nothing but praises. Like, you're amazing. You're a great friend. Girl, you... I still don't forgive you for what you did to Ace. And Ace wasn't in this episode, boo. I'm gonna scratch in my head on the thing for... Anywho, Nick was supposed to be helping George and he takes off with Nancy, which pisses me off. Anyways, they get to the guy's house and there's water just pouring out. And there's a door and there's ghosts behind it and they're like banging on the glass. And he's like, we got to get him out. And so Nick and Nancy's just watching him. And Nick trying to open up the door. He's like, no, it's not real. He's being hunted. And they have a heart to heart. You know, everybody got to have a heart to heart. So heart to heart and everything. I don't know how to say the survivor's name. And I don't really want to mess up. I think it's Bashir. But he shows them something. Basically evident about, you know, what happened. Because he said he used it as a shield. And I think it was a bomb inside of it. Then the next thing we have Nancy. She meets up with Ryan Hudson. Which was pointless. It was such a pointless scene. Because she was asking him for advice. And he really wasn't helpful. Then Nick goes back to the shack and George is clearly annoyed as she rightfully should with him running off with Nancy. And she just straight up tells him like, you just basically, when she says jump, you say how high. That's not what she said, but that's basically what she's saying. Because whenever she needs you, you just run off. You can tell, you know, there's something going on. I can't wait till they get together. Nancy shows up at the Hudson's dinner party, the Hudson and Marvin's dinner party, which... I didn't know Bess was going to be there, but Bess is like, Nancy ain't paying her no attention. She tells Everett, like, okay, I got what you need. Let's go talk. And I didn't know it was a setup this whole time between her and Owen. I didn't know. Long story short, he gets arrested. And then Nancy sees, for some reason, she goes upstairs. I don't know what pressed her to go upstairs. I don't think I was really paying attention to that scene after Everett got arrested. And the mom was freaking... Nancy goes upstairs and she finds her mom's file in the Hudson's house. Which, really? How did they get that? Like, how did you get those particular files that were torn out, but that was in a cupboard of her stairs? Like, how did you get... They don't be answering some of these questions, but maybe they will in the next episode. Then Nancy's outside. She's about to leave. And then Owen comes out and he's like, "Ooh, I like arguing with you." And then they make out. Well, they don't really make out, they kiss. And he asks her out on a date and she declines. And he's like, is this about Nick? And she's like, it's not always about a boy. And she leaves, which it's always about a boy. Girl, stop lying. Then Ryan Hudson is talking to his mom outside. And he's like, it's about time that I took over. Like, you have no authority, you weakling. Then we have Lisbon and Bess. They're so cute. But Lisbon's... You know, she tells Bess that she thinks that she's falling in love. I'm like, falling. That she's falling in love. And as cute as they are, they just met. Can y'all slow down? It's been like 2 weeks. Come on. I think it's been longer than that, but they haven't been dating that long. Like, you in love already? I mean, I guess this is one of those things when you know, you know. But jeez, come on. Anyways, Lisbeth and Bess, they had a little moment. They so... I see y'all. Anyways, we have Nick and he teams up with George and he buys the restaurant. Like, duh, we knew that was gonna happen. And basically she's like, did you buy me a restaurant? He's like, no, we're a team. Like, you can reward it all you want, but you just bought her a restaurant, bruh. Okay, we know what's up. So we have Nick and George, they had a little cute moment. And then next we have Mrs. Hudson is making mafia phone calls. Girl, I don't know who she thinks she is, but she's making mafia phone calls in late at night trying to get Carson Drew murdered. Sis, go sit down somewhere, Susan. Not only because he knows things about them, but she wanted to send a message to Nancy. Like, rich people really don't know what to do with their money. That's what you wasting time, you wasting money, you wasting resources. Just be better people. Anyways, that is all. Until next time, I really did like this episode because I got to see more of Nick and George. But can we be done with this shipwreck conversation? Because I really think that it's boring. Like, if the show was like back in like the 1970s or 1960s, the shipwreck conversation would make sense. But right now, we in 2000 and what, 20, and you want to talk about a shipwreck? I just don't feel like it's not a bad storyline, but it's not great either. It's boring, but that's my opinion. So until next time, bye guys.
I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why I'm down, yeah? No friends of mine around, yeah. Now I'm thinking of by the cottage room blues, yeah. I wanna drown myself inside the juice, yeah. You know I keep on running from the I'm just a lonely fucking you. Now when I drive around, don't feel it up. Why it's getting colder when the sun come out? Might just waste away, don't know what life about. Another day go by, don't know what got me down. June blues, yeah, I got the June blues, yeah. Walk down like who you. Get used to. me breaking, 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 breaking. I was present, hopeless, praying, 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 praying. Struck down at 20, plenty left to put behind you. You ain't peaked, devil's peeking, now they speaking about you, leave it alone. Hope you grinning while you watch your bros on some soulful sunny shit to brighten up a wounded soul. Honest, you